like, you can't. Yeah, but he said that he would turn down the lights. And Cody disappeared.
Also, it's...
I kind of don't. I know.
Plus, that's 3 minutes.
Folks, hi. How's it going? Hey, so we're here at the Christmas concert. I'm so glad to have you here. It's been a pretty interesting year. It's a time that it's kind of hard to run like a band program, but somehow, you know, actually with the, you know, kids at home actually practicing, you know, during quarantine, you know, actually just actually making it happen, and it's been great, so thank you for that. Yes, thank you. So I think it's going to be fun tonight. I know it's going to be fun. I just wanted like to share a thought about the night, and it's from Luke 2. And it's about the shepherds. In verse 8, it says, there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came unto them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were very afraid. But the angel of the Lord said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, and it shall be for all people. And I think in verse 17, it talks about the good news of Christ. I mean, I think right now in our world, on the news, there's actually a lot of bad news, you know. And what's awesome about this season is that it's full of great news. And I was actually thinking about the shepherds, and the shepherds were just in the flock, you know, actually minding their business, taking care of their, you know, sheep. And the angel of the Lord actually came on, you know, to them. And I was thinking, like, what would, like, you know, actually, what was it like? And is it possible that their life would actually never be the same after that, you know? Just one word, you know, from God completely, you know, actually changed. So the thought that I had for this night, for this season, it's Christmas, and you know, we've, you know, been through Christmas. We actually know what it's like, but maybe this Christmas is completely different. Like, maybe, you know, God has something fresh and new for us this season. So with that being said, like, I want to get started with the night. And Lindsay Chase, what child is this?
Shepherds guard and angels.
Okay, so we have a fourth and fifth grade band. So my fourth graders have been playing for 3 months. So just to get them like to play a song is like awesome, right? It's cool. And I have a couple of fifth graders that have been playing for a couple years, Brody and Isaiah. Having a hard time on the mask. And we're gonna play Jingle Bells for you. Here we go. So good. That was the Jansen sisters, all three of them. So glad they're in a band. Okay, so next a song is going to feature our sixth grade class and also a seventh grader, Emily Hofsis on the piano, Linda Brown on the flute, Joshua Goody on the trumpet, Sophia Rodriguez on the clarinet. The First Noel. Here we go. Sixth grade, come on, killing it. Okay, so next is my middle school choir. So we're gonna sing a fun tune, Mary's Boy Child. And then after that, we're singing Mary Did You Know, songs about Mary, like we're talking a lot about Mary tonight. And that song is featuring a few of them. It's Elle, right? Jansen, Bella Pellegrino, Judea, is Nick? Nick and Ace. Okay, come on up.
Microphone.
Can I use this one too, please? Sorry.
Mary's boy.
Okay, yes, awesome. Wow, like it's only 5:30, guys. Gonna have to make up some songs to fill the time. Anyone wants to sing? Come on up here. I'm just joking, please don't come up here. Okay, so next is our concert band. I'm proud of these guys. So last spring, as you know, we left school in March, right? Like the first week of March. And I was thinking, my band program, these kids aren't going to practice at home. It's going to be a step back. And they didn't practice at home. But the fall came, and I just felt this like excitement for one, not being home, and two, like playing music with their friends and something like constructive. So and I've like heard that this year. We've like taken a big step forward. Not to put any pressure on you guys, but the first song we're gonna sing is Silent Night. Play, not sing.
Thank you.
Come on. Hello? Hello? Okay. That was good. Come on, right? Killing up here. All right, okay. So the next piece is the Nutcracker. This is like our capstone piece of the semester. So we're doing three movements. It's the march from the Nutcracker, the dance of the Sugar Plum Fairy, and the Russian dance. So it's not very long. Like, it's not. It's like 2 minutes, guys. It's the shortened version. But it's a fun piece, and you actually know the tune. They like playing it, and I think you can tell, you know. All right, cool. Awesome. Awesome, huh? They've come a long way. So my first class was in fourth grade, and now they're in eighth grade, which is crazy. And if you came to one of those first concerts, you would be like amazed how far it's come. Okay. So the next tune is the last tune of the night. Wow. I'm kind of sad about that. Months of hard work for 40 minutes. That's it. So this last song is "O Holy Night." It's a barn burner, right? It can turn, I know we have mass on, but if you want to sing, please sing. So please welcome Emmanuel and Olga. Nice and wide.
Holy night, the stars are brightly shining.
So that's it. There's a few people I don't want to thank. I don't have their gifts with me because I left them home. But Annette Bennis, please stand up. She helped me with all my flute players, my clarinet players, Kim Shibley, whose birthday was yesterday. My best friend, Kim Shibley, over there. Tim Angelonis, is he here? Nope. Well, he helps out with the saxophone players. Zoe Turk just helps me not look like a fool. The band tonight, Hajan Reynolds, Mr. Anu Iyer, and Gavin Pereira. And thanks to all the parents. Make sure your kids practice. It's gonna get better and better and better. Keep practicing. And let's finish out with a prayer. Pastor Barry, you want to pray for us?
Yes, let's thank Mr. Thompson. Little known secret, early on in the band program, they used to have an office right next to mine. And I can tell you, they have improved immensely. Let's give them another great hand. What a great effort. Parents, I know you know this, but your kids are the greatest. We really believe that they're the greatest, and it's because of the investment in your lives in them. So thank you for co-laboring with us. Let's just have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the opportunity that we have to have school, Lord, in-person learning in these crazy days, God. It's a gift from you. Thank you for keeping us and protecting us and for developing incredible young men and women, Lord, that grow in grace and knowledge and have a foundation that is meaningful and is impactful and will go from here and affect the world, their families. And we are just so grateful, Lord, that in this city of Baltimore, we can have an impact for the gospel. And it's amazing. And we rejoice and we give you the glory. In your precious name, amen. Thank you for coming. We really appreciate it. There's a service that follows this, and then don't forget on Wednesday we have our elementary extravaganza at 6 o'clock. So come and join.